Radio Yisroba. Radio Yisrofil. Radio Yisroba. Radio Yisroba.
Welcome to the leading internet radio station in the Mother City. There are many ways to stream our shows. Visit us on our Facebook page, live at Radio East River. Also, visit us on our website, www.radioeastriver.co.za, or download the Radio East River app, available and supported on any and all smart devices. Radio East River, die ding ruk hier.
I wanna know you more. Our station, our talent, our people.
Didang Raki.
Hello, hello, hello. You're at the right place. Yes, you're part and parcel of the show here on radio, the most listened to radio in the Cape Flats, I assume, and that is Radio Easter River. And that's the station for our people, their talents, onse stasie, onse mense, onse talente. And you with the program On the Couch with Doc. And I've got the privilege to stand in for Dr. Graham Albertine today. He is busy working in Pretoria. He's all busy with the logistics of our newly elected president. Congratulations to our newly president as well. And he's in Pretoria whilst we're busy doing this program. And hopefully he will be back next week. And I saw him already. He's listening in. And Dr. Graham, it's going well here in Cape Town. Lovely weather and so on. And we're looking forward to see you again. And the listeners, as you sit there on the couch, get hold of a little bit of coffee and so on. And we will have a discussion today about what we have done the previous Sunday. And you can remember that. That was Father's Day. That was the day for the youth on Monday. But especially we want to concentrate on the subject, the importance of the impact of fathers in our lives. That is what our discussion is all about today. And I want you to just leave what you are doing, sit on the couch, and participate in the program today, because every one of us has got a father. Every one of us has got memories of a father. There's a lot of fathers there outside and so on, and you are the head of a family, and you know that to be a father is not so easy. And with fatherhood comes responsibility. And to father a child is easy on the one hand. But to raise a child, to be the leader of your family structure, to be there for your loved ones, to be a good father, that's the thing that we want to talk about this morning. And therefore, call your friends and be part of the program today. And as I put it, I'm standing in for Dr. Graham Albertine today, but he will be here next week for the next program. And I really feel honored, to be in his shoes today. And let's see how it goes. Therefore, I think we'll take the first break in our music and shine a light. That is Michael Browning that is singing this lovely song. And you will see the music that we've chosen and so on is all about fatherhood. And it's not difficult to talk about fatherhood from a Christian perspective, because we've also got our Heavenly Father. And that is the thing that we must put on the table. The interplay between the Heavenly Fatherhood on the one hand side, and then the fact that we are fathers here in this life today. And what is the interplay between it? And I think this song will enlighten us and help us to shine a light on the whole perspective of what is a father, what is the Heavenly Father for all of us. Let's listen. Shine a Light, Michael Browning.
Our station, our talent, and our people. our station, our talent, and our people.
Aha, Shine a Light. That is the song that we listen, the instrumental, the lovely piano music, the bass, the chords, Shine a Light. And our subject for this morning, all our listeners, and I hope you're sitting with a little bit of coffee there on the couch. You're with the program On the Couch with Dr. Francois Swart. I'm standing in for Dr. Graham Albertain this morning. And our subject this morning, very important, the importance and impact of fathers in our lives. And I want to ask you a very personal question there. As you sit there with the things that you are thinking about, the day, your life, where are you? How's it going with you? And especially in terms of our subject, if you think in terms of your father, what is your memories that you've got of your father? And you know how it goes. In this sort of subjects, when you talk about your mothers, your children, your boss, you know, at work, your neighbor, your friends, and also then our subject of the morning, the impact of our fathers in our lives, it's a two-way stream. You can have fond memories. When you think about that person and the fathers this morning in the lovely Cape Town area, and the lovely day that the Lord, our Father, has given us, you can have fond memories, and you can think, you know, I'm so glad that I've got this specific, unique Father that Father God has given me. And I will, for the rest of my life, I will be so glad and be grateful to the Heavenly Father that He bestow me with this special Father that He has given me, that bring life to in my bring me, father me, be there for me, and so on. But then we must talk about the shadow side as well. In the South African context, there's a lot of households that haven't got the privilege to have a father. There is no father in the household. And the mother or the older brother or sister, they have to take responsibility of the household. They have to give guidance to the family structure. And when you hear about fatherhood and of your own dad and so on, then we tend to talk about, hey, how's it going with you? And especially if you think of your history and so on, have you got daddy issues? Have you got some wounds in terms of when you think about your father, that he is the instigator of emotional wounds in your life? That you've got terrible thoughts about your father. And that is then what we have to talk about. And especially when you are the father and listen to the program today, I think we as fathers have to ask ourselves the question, what is it this father would think? What is the important factors? What is the goals as a father that is very important to us? And I think we have to define fatherhood. In the view of the nature to be a father, you know, we know in terms of fatherhood and the raising of a family, to get hold of a wife, the suitable wife, to start a family. The initiative is coming from the father. And then to talk about in this program, till about 12 o'clock this morning, about what is the essence of fatherhood. And if I'm a father, what can I do to be a better father? To be a father that my people, that the Lord has bestowed on me, my family members, how can I be a better father for them? In this regard, I want to refer to our newly elected president, You know, I listened to his speech yesterday, and the part of his speech that struck me, when he stand in front of us and say, okay, I'll take up this huge thing of the presidency on my shoulders for a second term, but I'm standing here before you as your humble servant. And I think from a Christian perspective, that is very important. When you are in the capacity of power, when you're in the capacity of a position, and especially he is in a sense the father of the nation, he has to lead us, he has to guide us, and so on. And then to proclaim before his people that he wants to be humble, he wants to be a servant. I think we have to take a page out of President Cyril Ramaphosa's speech then yesterday. How can we apply that notion in our reign, in our lives as a father with our family that the Lord has given to us? And can we say as our president, I'm standing here as a humble father, I'm here, I don't want to play the power game, I'm here to serve my people, I'm here to serve my wife, I haven't got the expectancy that they have to serve me, my children as well, I want to be there for them. I think that is the important departure point of this discussion when we talk about what is the essence of fatherhood from a Christian perspective. But there's another thing that strikes me when I think about our subject today, the importance and the impact of fathers, and I think of my own father, and that is a referral to the English language. You know, there's a lot of languages all over the universe, I assume. We think there's aliens, we don't know about it. But we know, you know, there's all around the universe, there's sounds that is coming to us. And then language, the birds is making sound, the animal life is making sounds. But when human makes sounds and certain languages are making sounds, there is certain portions of that sounds that struck you, that you in a certain way just have to think about it and you have to ponder about it. And in terms of our subject, the importance and impact of fathers, I think what is applicable here, you know, in the English language, when you talk about the sexes, you can refer to a woman as a lady, to a man, a boy, and so on. But the word that is one of the most wonderful words for me in the English language, and I think we have to unpack it in terms of our subject this morning, is the word gentleman. And as you sit there on the couch, on the pouch, I want to ask you, think about this word for a moment. Gentleman. What is a gentleman? And when you unpack this word, we're talking about a man, we're talking about a husband, we're talking about a boy, but the thing of this word, this combination word, gentle boy, gentle husband, gentleman, gentleman. And I hope you can see what I'm heading for and why I'm putting it on the table in our discussion. And you as a father and as a man, do you think you are gentle? Is that what God the Father is asking from us? To be gentle? To be the leaders? To be humble like our president? To be a servant? And I think that is the uniqueness of the Christian perspective when we talk about fatherhood. The essence then, I think the departure point is we have to talk about this gentleness. And why are we struggling to be gentle as fathers? Why is it that our family members, our wife, don't perceive us as gentle? And therefore, I think it's a very important subject this morning. Please, if you can, talk to me. Also, it will be great on the platform, Radio Easter Rivers platform. We are live there, and your comments that will I will welcome it. And let's get the discussion started in terms of the importance and impact of fathers in our lives, because we need a special touch. I think that's what it's all about. That is what Kim Waters is singing. Kim Waters, I don't know how to pronounce it, but let's make it Waters. Kim Waters is going for the music break, and I think the song is about the special touch. And I really think a father is bringing, in terms of the family structure, he can bring a special touch. Let's listen to this next song.
Our station, our talent, and our people. our station, our talent, and our people.
Fatherhood, that's our subject, the impact and the importance of our fathers in our lives. I think that's very important. But we must be honest about the subject. As you sit there on the couch and so on, there is people, and I want to introduce a next sort of word. Yes, the gentleness is important, but the fact is, in my life, I can say to you unequivocally, my father has wounded me. I carry a lot of wounds in my mind, in my soul, about what my father has done to me. And someone is writing about that wound. A father wound is the experience of pain from having a father who was not able to meet your basic emotional needs in childhood. Somebody else is writing Charles saying, and the results of a child being raised without his father's involved can be involvement, or the father's involvement can be just as devastating as a plane with one wing. I just want to reiterate it. And the results of a child being raised without his father's involvement can be just as devastating as a plane with one wing. I think this is, there's a lot of research being done, the impact of a father in the household. In the South African context, we've mentioned it in the introduction of the program, a lot of family structures goes without a father, and there's a lot of reasons for that. It can be loss, it can be accidental, it can be behavioral patterns, it could be that the marriage don't work out properly, and therefore the family structure is now alone, and the mother is struggling with an extended family to raise the children. And therefore, the absence of the father is recognizable in that family structure. Also, the substance abuse and so on. The father is there, but the presence of the father is so devastating and so destructive that his family dreams of the day, can you believe it, that I haven't got a father anymore? Because the father is introducing so much pain. And Dr. Francois, you are talking about gentleness. I don't know what you are talking about. And you know, from a Christian perspective and in the religion sphere, the importance of the triune God, we know that the first person is the Father God himself. Jesus is talking whilst he's busy with his ministry all the time with his Father. And there is more than one word, that we utilize for the word Father. In Hebrew, you can talk about the Abba, a word that is roughly translated in Afrikaans as Papa. This is Turtle Naam. This is Speciale Naam. The Lord is like my dad. He's like my Papa. He's the one that is looking after me. He is the one that has got a plan for me. He is the one that is protecting me. And we know that the Father's impact in a boy's life and the father's impact in a daughter's life is different, and we have to talk about it. But I first want to make about this huge responsibility of the emotional presence of our fathers, the way that we are in our families, the way that we carry ourselves, how we announce ourselves, how we talking with our wives and our children, I think it's very important to make a few remarks about it. And I think the first thing that we have to say to each other in this program, we must understand there isn't such a thing like a perfect father. There isn't a thing like a perfect father. Also, for fathers are people that is broken. It could be that they are broken in themselves because of their fathers and because they haven't received a good example how to be a good father. Therefore, this subject is so important this morning that we talk about and give a few ideas and principles. We're talking about these principles, how to be a good father, how to be a gentle father. And therefore, I think this subject that Dr. Graham has gift to us to talk about is very important in our day. But the role of the father can be very good in terms of the emotional capacity. I think we as men, we as fathers, we must not underestimate the effect of the emotional impact that our presence had in our family structures. And therefore, the research showed to us that children, and especially the woman and your wife and so on, when they experience a sense of closeness of the father, that brings security, that brings emotional stability that can be very helpful for the children as well as the wife to cope with everyday life, to get close to your children. And we will talk about practical ways to become close to your family people, the people that you take responsibility for. I think the other thing is to carry warmth, you know, in terms of your presence, to talk a little bit softer and to ask questions, not to judge, but because you really want to know what your loved ones is experiencing in their work environment, in their school environment, and so on. To give some time. You as a father is a space creator, an atmosphere builder, where people that comes in your midst, and especially your loved ones and your children, that they're not afraid, but that they feel secure, that they really experience emotional security. I think the third thing is that is very important. There must be a sense of attachment. And the wonderful thing for me is when I'm a grandfather now, and you know the thing that tickle me when I haven't seen them for the week and so on, and it's almost like your dog, you know. You know, when your dog for 4 or 5 hours, the dog haven't seen you, away with work and so on, and then you come back, how you know the atmosphere changed with that dog and his happiness that you are there. His tail is wagging and so on, and he's jumping up and down and so on. And that's the same with my grandchildren. You know, if I haven't seen them for the week, and I'm approaching them again, the most wonderful thing is that they come running to me, they jump into your arms and so on. That is a sense that something is going right in this relationship. They long for you. You long for them. There's a sense of attachment. you have to build constantly on a lifelong bond. And that lifelong bond is forming, and you have to work on it all the time. Now, the bond, that is very interesting. Ons praat in Afrikaans van die verbond, the covenant in the Old Testament. And God the Father in the Old Testament also wants to be with us as his children. He wants to be with us in a journey, a lifelong journey. Therefore, he creates the covenant with Abram, the father of the believers. And he takes the initiative as the heavenly father. And he constitutes this relationship in terms of an attachment that we call the covenant. And this covenant is constructed in a way that it's a lifelong attachment. And in this relationship, there's a give and take sort of interplay between the child, between the husband and wife, between the father and his children. There's a playfulness. There's humor. There's questions that we are asking. There's questions and answers that you are giving. There's a conveying of wisdom. I think it's a huge responsibility to be a father. The problem is how to make it practical in our everyday life. When you left the house at the beginning, what is it, 6 o'clock in the mornings, and only arrive at 8 o'clock in the evenings. Time is so limited. How can we go about in our modern way of life to become a good father, to become a gentle father, to become a father that can serve and really be a good father for the people? That is the thing that we have to talk about. To have a kind heart, that is the important thing. And that is what Steve Oliver is singing about. And I hope, especially our men, the gentlemen, the fathers, that when you listen to this song, that will be your prayer. Give me a kind heart. Help me to bring that security about in my family structure. That's what I'm long for. That's the reason why I'm a father. Yes, I want to be a gentleman. I want to be a gentle father. I want to be a father that brings wisdom to my family and creates safe spaces where they can strive and enjoy their life. Let's listen to this wonderful piece of music of Steve Oliver. Oh Lord, give me a kind heart.
Our station, our talent, and our people. talent and our people.
Butcher's Market offers the best quality, locally sourced and 100% halal meats. Visit our store at Tambury Square Mall. Contact us at 021-565-0499 TPM for your halal meats.
You are listening to Radio Yesterova.
Hello, hello, hello. You are part and parcel of our program On the Couch with Doc. It's Dr. Francois Swart that's with you, and we have got the discussion about a very important discussion, the importance and impacts of fathers in our lives. And I'm standing in for my colleague, Dr. Graham Albertain. I see on the platform, Leonie Mayer, it's great that you are listening in. Letitia Sauls, yes, it's great to have you in our company. Dr. Graham himself is listening in. Thank you for the encouragement, brother and colleague. And it's wonderful, all the people that is participating, and also for the fact that you make this program possible, because you are here and you are participating and you are encouraging, and thanks for that. I think the important thing as we proceed, what are some of the most important values and lessons fathers should instill in their children? What is the five processes, the five ducks that a father can be on the lookout for? Bring that five ducks in a row, and I just have want to go quickly from duck to duck, if I can put it in that way. What is the five very important elements in fatherhood? And I think the first thing that a father has to bring into his family structure is the whole notion that people, when they talk to each other, when they work with each other, it must be with respect. Now, you see, that is a very important thing. What can happen, because you think you are the father, you are the older one, you are the one in age that is the oldest, and so on. You can feel that you are the most important figure in the structure. In the sense, you are right. But when it goes to your head in a certain sense, that you become a powerful figure because you are bringing in the money into the system of the family, and therefore you ask from your people to abide you, to listen to you when you talk. I think we have to readdress the whole notion of respect. Respect is something that you can't force on people. You know, respect is something that you steadily build brick by brick. And I think it's in the small things that you are creating respect. The way that you treat the mum of the children, the way that you talk to the mother, that will show, and you will imitate, in a sense, respect to the children. When we talk to each other as the mother and the father, the children must sense the way that mum and daddy is talking to each other. I can feel they do it with respect. And when you talk with a child, and your own child that is standing in front of you, I think it's very important that you come on their level in a very physical way. It's very important. You know, myself, my length is about 1.9 meters. And when you stand at the child that is, you know, is shorter than a meter. I'm quite a big fellow that with my presence, with my bodily presence, I'm overpowering that child. Now, in terms of respect, when your child is talking to you, just to kneel at your child so that you are on the same level, and you've got eye contact on the same level, to talk a little bit softer and to look your child really in the eye when they're busy talking to you. I think that is very important. We as mums, we are so busy in the kitchen and doing some stuff in the house. We as fathers, you know, you're working there in the garage, or you're busy with something, and your child start talking to you about something. I think in a practical sense, you can show respect just for a moment to leave the thing that you are busy with and look your child straight in the eye and make some time for him or her. Sit down with him and show the respect. I earnestly, as your father, want to understand what you are trying to convey to me. It's very good then, as the child trying to put over his emotional structure, the thing that he is struggling in his life, that you summarize it. What I'm hearing, my child, what you are saying to me is, this is what you are struggling with, and you try this option, that option is not working for you, and now you're frustrated and so on. You're in the cul-de-sac. You don't know how to go forward and so on. And let's talk about it. Have you think about this? To ask questions, not to be the quick fixer, but start a conversation in terms of the option of how to address the situation. Respect. And then the other thing I think that is very important, building block to be a good father, and to be always on the lookout if you can be an encourager, to encourage the people around you. Your child, when they are saying something good, doing something good, to encourage them, and so on. I think the third very important thing is the thing of affirmation. To recognize a person that I can see you've done your best. I can see you strive for the best. I recognize you and I affirm you. And I want to say, I'm really grateful that I am your father. And I'm grateful that you are my child. And that you say it to the mother of that child. The role of affirmation, the role of encouragement, the role of showing respect, and so on. But you also have got, in the second last place, you've got this a role to restrain, to bring the boundaries into place. But you must walk the talk and talk the walk. And you can't say to the people and to your children especially, you know, we don't swear in this house, but in the next sentence you are swearing to your neighbor. You can't say, you know, we don't drink in this house, do as I say, don't do what I do, and then you just carry on with your drinking habits and so on. You have to explain it to your children, to the people around you. You must be example in terms of how you are restraining you in certain situations in a responsible way. And then the last one, I think, what is a very important thing in terms of fatherhood is the role of the teacher. You know, as you drive by here in the Boerland, in Cape Town, when you see the mountains and so on, start talking to your a little child that is under five in terms of age and say, do you see that lovely mountain? What do you think? How this mountain, how is it coming about? What do you think of the Creator? What do you think of the moon that you are seeing, the big ocean there? Can you see the vastness and start to utilize the situation to talk about God, God the Father? In the next portion of the program, I want to talk about this whole thing of the fatherhood, our earthly father and our heavenly father, and how we has got a responsibility, because the fact is, when haven't got a good earthly father image, it could be that you are struggling in church then and in religion environments with the father concept as well. But that's the five things then. Be an encourager. Be someone that shows respect. And then you will found respect for your fatherhood. Be full of affirmation. Restrain you in a certain way and how you carrying yourself. Draw the lines in the sand and show and talk about the boundaries of your family structure and be a good teacher. And I think if we listen to this next song, Be Unstoppable. Adam Hawley is singing about, as a father, you must be unstoppable in terms of the energy of goodness that you want to bring to your loved ones. They must see that your love is unstoppable and that you are a good forgiver and you are proud of them. Let's listen to this song, Unstoppable, of Adam Hawley.
Radio East River. Radio East River. Radio East River. Radio East River.
You are listening to Radio Yesterova.
Yes, and you are part and parcel of the program On the Couch with Doc, and I'm Dr. Francois Swart. I'm standing in for my colleague, Dr. Graham Albertine, today. Our subject for this morning is how to become a good father, the importance and impact of fatherhood. That's what we're talking about. And I just read something here in a book. A son can make the most stupid life decisions. He can misbehave. But a good father will never give up on his son, because a son is his reflection. A son is his reflection of Mum Junction. Let's talk about this reflection. You see, the whole concept of father is a huge concept, because it is part and parcel of the way how we are thinking about life in general, and especially when we talk about our religion from a Christian perspective. The way that we are describing God, the concept of God, is in the first place with this word, Abba, Father. Therefore, it's very important that we've got the right understanding of a good perspective of what we really mean when we utilize the word Father. Now, therefore, I think it's very important that we ask, what is the impact of our father's presence in our lives, and their involvement in their children's emotional development and the psychological development. That is very important, but we can add your perception. Every Sunday when you're in church and you utter the words of the triune God, and that is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, what is your perception in a religion setting of the Father? And what we see in Scripture and so on is that the Father is our protector. He is the person that journey with us. He is the one that is looking after us. He is the one that is concerned about us. He is looking out for the enemies and try to protect you from harm and so on. Now, if you live in an environment as a child and your earthly father is not doing these things, you can think by yourself, as you sit there on the couch, what huge impact it had when the minister is standing on the pulpit and talk to you and say, you have to understand, God is like a father. And now your referral point is your earthly father, and you haven't got this fond memories of your heavenly father. And therefore, the interplay between fatherhood in the earthly sense and the Father of the heavens, our heavenly Father, the Father of Jesus Christ, our Father, and the fact when we pray, our Father that is in heaven, what are we really saying? I think the first remark that we have to make in terms of the emotional development and the psychological development of our children is the huge responsibility that we have got as fathers on our shoulders. We are busy enshrining and ingrinding a certain way of thinking about our Heavenly Father. And we are an example, in a sense, of what a father is supposed to do in our lives. And therefore, our fathers must listen very carefully how we can enhance our fatherhood. And I think the important thing is start reading about it. You know, if you go on the internet and you just put on the search engine, you know, fatherhood, there's a lot of articles and stuff that you can read about to be an effective father on the emotional side, on the marriage side, on to the upbringing of your children, in terms of the teaching aspects, to be a good teacher as a father, to be a good spiritual leader to your people. That is things that there's a lot of things that is already written about it, and broaden your knowledge base about this huge responsibility to become a father. And I think if we know this and say, okay, all these things are available, I take it, I have to find some time and utilize it and start reading about it. I think we must start talking about, now, what if my circumstances, and as I listened to this program this morning, I am in this predicament. You know, there's a history in my family. I've done stuff wrong. I haven't do things the right way. It's easy to talk about fatherhood in a positive sense of the way. But the fact of the matter is, I think as I listen to this program today and this discussion, I'm not a good father. I'm struggling to be a good father. Now, we will talk a little bit about that. But I first want to talk to the victims of bad fatherhood. You as a child, as you sit there with tears in your eyes, and you listen to this whole subject today, what is there for me in this program this morning? Is there some hope for me? And I think the very important thing is that you must start writing about your wounds. If you are over 40 years in age, if you sit there and you say, I've got bad memories and so on, it's very important that you start writing about it, that you start journaling about it. Get hold of a book. And all these feelings, all these bad memories that you've got about your father, bring it out. Bring it out of your system. Don't carry it in your mind all the time. And that it be part and parcel of your inner structure anymore. Bring it out in the sense on a piece of paper. Number it. Put the dates in, recognize the wounds. That is the path of healing that you can pursue if you sit there and say, you know, I'm listening to this program, but I have got daddy issues. And this daddy issues is haunting me. And I've got these memories, I've got nightmares about my daddy. How do you go about with it is start writing about it, thinking about it, and then it's very helpful to go to somebody nearby in the family and make sure that these things that you have written down, it's true. Because, you know, it's funny how the mind is working. And you can work with a myth in terms of your father as well. A good myth as well as a bad one. And therefore, it's very important that you check yourself with your siblings, with your mother, about your thoughts about your father. Is it correct? is my facts correct? Because there's a tendency, especially in therapy, and I'm working on a regular basis in a therapy environment, that when you cross-check the facts, what a person is saying about what has happened, it is not really true. It is something that is fabricated in the person's mind. Now, I'm not suggesting here that your feelings is fabricated. I think it's very important. That's the point I want to make, is that you take your own woundedness very, very seriously. And that's why we want to give you some guidelines to go about with your daddy issues, so that it don't become a stumbling block and take away all your happiness. And especially when you go to church and the minister is talking about Father God, you are not confused. That you can get hold of what is the gentle Father all about. Because the scripture is talking in lots of the stories in the Bible of the good Father, of the as the shepherd. As the Father that really love his sheep, has got a plan. We've heard of the covenant, and that he wants to journey with us, and that his our prosperity is important for him, and that he wants to be part and parcel of our life. That is the basic message of the of Christianity, is that God the Father is the one that wants to be there for us, to protect us in a spiritual sense, in an emotional way, in a psychological way, to guide us through his word, to bring spaces where people can grow and can flourish, to create wisdom in terms of the basic principles of love and respect, and just to be patient. That is one of very important characteristics of God the Father in the Bible. Despite of our bad decision making, he is still encouraging us. He's there for us. He forgives us. And he don't write us off and say, I'm not involved anymore. And therefore, the Father God in the Bible is portraying as the graceful one, as the one that comes to us through the cross and through Jesus Christ, our Lord, and give us new ways to look at our situations. And he is the one. You know, every time when we're near Christmas, it's Christmas. It's the time of the year when we celebrate the Christ in Christmas. But I know as a young minister, I wonder about it. Is Christmas not really in its essence a Father fest? Because it's the Father that has bring this wonderful plan of his Son, Jesus Christ, into being. And he is the one that proclaims Jesus as his Son and as the hope for our salvation, for our world, for to strive for real happiness is to understand that our Heavenly Father has got a plan, and he lives through us through his Holy Spirit, and he is there for us. Therefore, the interplay between the earthly Father and the Heavenly Father is very important. But on the other hand, to summarize, we've spoken about when there is some woundedness because of your earthly Father, you have to work on it. And therefore, I want to conclude this section of the program to say, get hold of something. You were with a family member. The facts are correct. You carry some wounds about your father and so on. You know that's true and so on. But you still are struggling with your emotions. I think then it's important to get hold of a professional person. You have to go to a mentor. You have to go to a therapist that will help you in terms of your feelings that you are and the woundedness that your father has created in your life. It's not necessary to be stuck in that wounds. There is a way out, and that is the important thing that we have to understand. And in that sense, that portion of instrumental music with the subject unstoppable, we can be, as Christians, as followers of Jesus, as for Father God, we can be unstoppable in terms to rectify also our history in terms of the bad thing that has happened between us and our fathers. There is hope that you can fall back on and start working in a certain way. And I think if you're struggling on your own, get hold of a professional, a therapist, and sort this thing for once in your life out. And let the wounds, the daddy wounds, yield and go on with your life and concentrate you, especially if you are a man, to be then a good father, a gentleman, as we've put it. I think let's go to the next song of Basil Benford. That's a dedication song. And when you listen to this song, let's dedicate ourselves as fathers to this huge responsibility that the Lord has put on our shoulders, to be gentle fathers, to be fathers with wisdom. Let's close our eyes and listen to this song and ask the Lord, Father, help me. I want to be a dedicated father, a father like our Heavenly Father.
Hey, Mr. Brown, feeling down? Listen to the leading internet radio station in Cape Town. Verpletter plezier, luister naar Radio Eerste Rivier. Dis ons stasie, ons talent en julle bly lekker, onze mensen.
our station, our talent, and our people.
I say, welcome on the radio, Yesteriver. That's the radio that you have to listen to, and especially this program, On the Couch with Dr. Francois Swart this morning. I'm standing in for my colleague, Dr. Graham Abeltrain, that is working in Pretoria, and so on. He'll be back to you, if the Lord permits, next week, and be in his chair and present the program. Our subject this morning is the importance of fatherhood, and I think we have to start, conclude and summarize what we have said in the last 2 hours in our discussion about the very important role that the father is playing in their children and in their wife's life. What is the key elements that make fathers influential in the lives of their children and their environment? And is there any advice we can give on a practical level for fathers that is seeking to improve their relationship with their children? I think there's a lot to say about it. And I think the most important thing is, let's talk again about that gentleness. Talk softer. Be on their level. Give them time. Now, what sort of time? And I think especially over weekends, the most wonderful thing that the father can do with his children is to play with his children. You know, an ordinary ball, to go to the park nearby and just play with your children, that is wonderful. There on the mat, just in Afrikaans, to stream met hulle. Jy weet, sommer net so lekker met hulle. En dat jy nou maar die donkie is en hulle ry bo op jou en jy kruip maar die hele wêreld vol en jy lag saam. Praktiese goed wat jy kan doen. I think other thing, we men, and that's true of fathers, we like to eat, isn't it? Yeah. Yes, we like to eat. You must eat, you know. And I think especially the breakfast on, in weekends, Saturday and Sunday, it's very good to have a late breakfast with one of your children. You know, if the Lord bestowed 3 or 4 children, give you 4 or 3 children, you father 3 or 4 children, I think it's very important. I can remember in my own life, I've got 2 children now. I've got all together. I've got 8 children to look after. Also, the husband and wives of my own blood children, and then the little ones and so on. Just to go to the Wimpy, for instance, and have an ordinary breakfast with one of them. And that's a wonderful thing. Just for an hour, you and that person, that child, is in the car, and it's only you and him or her. Her and you. Him and you. And you're in alone in each other's company. And you're on your way to the cafe where you will have a breakfast, a coffee shop, or whatever. And you are... You've got his hand in yours, and you're talking about life, about his friends. How's it going with his school? What is his interest? What is the things that he loves about? What is the stuff that he likes? What is, the things that he wish for in life? But to have that special time, and there's 4 weekends in a month, and you can be very practical in terms in your diary. Put it down, structure it, and your wife understand it, That's your father time with your children. Don't take them all together, but take them one by one. You know, as you sit there on the couch as a father, every child has got its own unique personality. And therefore, you have to adapt. You can have three children, but in terms of their personality structure, the emotional structure, the phase of their life that they are in, the challenges that your various children are staring in the face is differently. And therefore, it's important that you take them aside. And I think to do it in a way that it's an activity. It's not come here in my study, come here in the room, I want to have a talk, come sit now, it's your father speaking now, look me in the eye, you can't go on like this. It's not that you become the minister and you start preaching to your child. But it's in the playfulness, in the park, while you're driving off to the coffee shop and so on. You start talking about his or her life and what's going on. Ask open questions and play with your child. Eat with him. I think other thing, if you haven't got the time that you can go, and because that is the most ideal way to connect with your child is in the individual way. From time to time, you can go with them to a spot, a picnic spot. You know, if you've got two or three boys, you go fishing, and you go to the nearest pond and so on. And for half of the day, you give them your time, and talk to them about life and the challenges of life and the importance to be a gentleman, especially for our women, and for the ladies, around us, to take responsibility. And if you sit there and say, you know, I listened to this program this morning, but I falter in my way to be a father. I think it's important that you get hold of your Heavenly Father again as an earthly father, and that you have a conversation. In the Greek tradition, it's very interesting for me. They've got in their tradition and so on. There was a time in my life that I take people overseas and so on and show them various countries and so on. And the Greek country was very interesting for me, the customs, family customs, and so on. When you go into a household of a Greek family, it could be that there is, you know, in the gate, there is a little box with candles and photos of loved ones that passed away. They put little lamps in there. And as you're coming into the house, you'll be confronted about the respect of the people that passed away already. But they are part and parcel of the family. You see the photos. You see the candle burning, or the light is shining. And then when you go into that homestead and so on, There is a corner back in the garden. There's standing a chair there, and the children, as they becoming older and so on, mother teach them. You know, when father is sitting there at the back in the garden, you have to keep silent, and you must understand what father is doing there. He's busy praying for us. He's busy talking to the Heavenly Father about each of us. And he is the one that talks and be the priest of the house in that very moment. Now, in our little flats that we are living in, we haven't got the luxury of a big garden outside and a tree and so on. But I want to challenge all the men and especially the fathers and so on. And if you want to be a gentleman and if you want to be a gentle father and you, if you want to be a father with wisdom, and so on, I dare you that your children catch you out one day, because of our houses that is so small. I think this thing can, very easily happen in a sense. That your child catch you once a month, once in 2 months, on your knees, in your room, there on your little carpet, by your bed, where you are on your knees, and that they understand. I can remember and recall a little child, some day run to their mother and say, "Mother, mother, you have to come and look. Father is on his knees there in the room. He's standing on his knee. There's something wrong with him." And then calmly the mom said to the child, "No, my dear, your father is praying for you." I want really that it's a good thing that your child see you as the head of the household, that you are also the one that is praying. You can do it as well before you eat. Let your people, let your wife, let your children take hands and just say a few words. "Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for each child here," and name them. And we know that our little daughter is struggling with a friend, and we pray for them. And we know that the other one is struggling with sickness or the subject on school, and we pray for them. And we know we worried about our finances. Lord, help us in this regard, so that the children can hear that the Father is the one that is conveying also the emotions and the things that he worried about in front of them before the Heavenly Father. In that sense, you show your humbleness. You show that you live according to the Heavenly Father. And by example, because you are a servant of the Heavenly Father, and be there for your children and your wife as well, I think then your life have purpose. You've got a reason to be a gentleman, to be a good father for your people. Therefore, don't be so harsh on yourself. Today is the day. This very moment is the moment that you can make a decision. I want to change gears. I want to be a father, as we have discussed in this program today. And therefore, I want to play out with this wonderful song of George Strait, "The Best Day, The Best Day." Could it be that this can be the first day of the rest of your life, that we can say that this is the best day because I've made a decision to change gear and to become a better father for my people, to show my people respect And as our president, and that's the way that we've started this program, I said yesterday to the whole country, I'm here, not in the first place as your president, but I'm here as your servant. I've hear you. I heard you. Yes, I will try my utmost best. He's in his second term. And therefore, I think we as fathers can go back in our lives to our families and start newly today to be the father that the Heavenly Father asks us to be for our people. Let's listen to this song, The Best Day of George Strait. Thank you. Keep well. And be good father to your people, please.
Our station, our talent, and our people.
We loaded up my old station wagon with a tent, a Coleman, and sleeping bags, some fishing poles, a cooler of Cokes, 3 days before we had to be back. When you're seven, you're in seventh heaven. When you're going camping in the wild outdoors, as we turned off on that old dirt road, he looked at me and swore, Dad, this could be the best day of my life. I've been dreaming day and night about the fun we'll have. Just me and you doing what I've always wanted to. I'm the luckiest boy alive. This is the best day of my life. His 15th birthday rolled around. Classic cars were his thing. When I pulled in the drive with that old vet, I thought that boy would go insane. When you're in your teens, your dreams revolve around four spinning wheels. We worked nights on end till it was new again. And as he sat behind the wheel, he said, Dad, this could be the best day of my life. I've been dreaming day and night about the fun we've had. Just me and you doing what I've always wanted to. I'm the luckiest boy alive. This is the best day of my life. In a little room back of the church with our tuxes on, looking at him I say, I can't believe, son, that you're grown. He said, Dad, this could be the best day of my life. I've been dreaming day and night of being like you. Me and her, watching you and Mom, I've learned I'm the luckiest man alive. This is the best day of my life. I'm the luckiest man alive. This is the best day of my life.
Last year, we made a commitment to ourselves.
Yes, it'll be.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Didang rag.